Good morning, Mr. Poole.
Oh, hello, Henry. Did you make up your mind?
Yes, Mr. Poole, but there's a little trouble.
A little trouble? Well, speak freely.
You see, I got the boys together, and I told them you wanted us to play the music for you at the restaurant.
That's right.
And for that, we'd get 10% of the business.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where the trouble started.
Oh, well, Henry, don't you think 10% enough?
Well, yes and no. Maybe it's enough, and maybe it's too much. But you see, Mr. Poole, there's 7 men in the band.
That's counting you.
That's right, counting me. And none of us know how to divide up 10% by 7. So if you could just only make it 7%.
Oh, 7%? Henry, it's a deal.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Poole. I told them cats you'd do the right thing.
Why, sure. Well, of course. I'll see you later. Yes, sir.
I'll tell you what's wrong.
Yes?
You see that one there?
Yeah.
That's a hen.
Yeah, I know.
See that one over there?
You mean the rooster?
That ain't no rooster.
Yeah. No, what is it? Hey, what's going on here? We're supposed to open tomorrow night. I come out and find you standing around gazing at a hen and a rooster.
2 hens, Mr. Poole.
Disaster. We've just discovered there can be no increase in the poultry department.
It's a beautiful time for that to happen. Now, what are we going to do for tomorrow night? How are we going to feed a lot of customers with only 2 hens?
Now, Mr. Poole, when do you have to have them chickens?
Well, we got to have them the first thing in the morning.
First thing in the morning?
Right.
And how many do you say you need?
Oh, got to have at least 50.
At least 50?
Yep.
Well, how many chickens does each man have to get when you need 50 chickens and you've got 7 men?
Well, if each man got 7 chickens, that'd be 49.
49?
Mm-hmm.
Well, Mr. Poole, I think we can do it.
You can?
Yes.
Well, if you do, I'll make it 14% instead of 7. That's 2% apiece.
Now, I know we can do it.
Oh, swell.
I'll tell you just how we're going to go about it.
Yeah?
As it gets dark tonight. There's an old deserted mansion on an old forgotten road where the better ghosts and goblins always hang out. One night they threw a party in a manner a la mode, and they cordially invited all the gang out. At a dark, bewitching hour, when the fun was loud and hearty, a notorious wallflower became the life of the party. The spooks were having their midnight fling. Mary Megan was in full swing. They shrieked themselves into a cheerful trance. When the skeleton in the closet started to dance. Now a goblin, he giggled with fiendish glee. A shout rang out from a big banshee. Amazement was in every ghostly glance. When the skeleton in the closet started to dance. Now all the witches were in stitches while his steps made rhythmic thumps. And they nearly dropped their broomsticks when he tried to do the bumps. You never heard such an earthly laughter or such hilarious groan. When the skeleton in the closet rattled his bones.
Thank you.
Bailey, that cat don't want no more meat. I'm telling you that, boy. Look at it.
One, two.
I don't know the art of elocution. I'm no good at thinking on my feet. I make no poetic contribution, even when you offer me a seat. I've thrown away expressions one by one. I'm at a loss, and something must be done. When we're in a friendly situation, my conversation may not be smart. But if we're to have a perfect understanding, let's call a heart a heart. There are words that should be whispered gently. That's evidently the way to start. If I tell you what my dreams have been demanding, let's call a heart a heart. Can I prove how I yearn just by the turn of a phrase? Can I keep my control when all my soul is ablaze? Maybe you would call a true confession an indiscretion on someone's part. But if I'm to say how madly I adore you, let's call a heart a heart.
There they are. Those are the fellas that stole our chickens.
Yeah.
We're out the lodge, gentlemen.